Hey everybody, it's for the world. Welcome back to P.T.O. We took over Hawaii last time, so now we are left with a decision here. To pursue the two subs, which I plan to do with a couple of my destroyer ships, but I'm also going to prepare for the invasion of San Francisco and Los Angeles. Now, I want to prepare these ships simultaneously, these fleets simultaneously to get there, which means I gotta wait a bit. As our carriers came back, I'm gonna get that fleet out there, but there really isn't much for them to do at this point. Because they have true transports, I need to wait. I want to get them headed towards Hawaii. As you see, the Allies got no ships this month, which is huge for me. That means now I know exactly what I need to do. I need to go, and I need to hunt those subs right now and get them done this month, which should prove to be promising. I have the 9th Fleet hounding, I have the 10th Fleet hounding them, the 6th Fleet's darting over, the 7th Fleet's going to dart over to Sarong and probably further. I'm going to send the 2 and 3 fleets over to Hawaii as well, just in case. But like I said, the 2, 3, and 4 fleets all have true transports, which means they're going to move slower than I am. I want to get them on a head start to Hawaii, and I want to make on the head start to Los Angeles, and I want to get them ready. As our 10th fleet now just hunted the Wahoo, and putting it on the brink. And then as they're about halfway there, I'm going to catch up to them. I want to tap both bases simultaneously. I don't want to wait. That's my point. I don't want to wait if I do this. But it looks like I might not have to wait. It looks like the Wahoo just kicked the bucket, so now we're just down to the Cacolot, wherever the heck that is. We have a general idea where it is, but we need to get some confirmation. So now it's just a matter of time. I got 25 days to do this, which is an eternity. The 5 Fleet, which just has destroyers in the Junio Magami, are going to be hunting around Saigon and Bangkok. The 6th Fleet is going to be going to Jakarta. The 7th Fleet is going to hunt around the Philippines and Singapore. And we're going to hopefully see a notification soon. And we did. The 6th Fleet just spotted the submarine. This is great. Now, everything's set. One submarine, 15 days. We are so close, we can taste it right now. So it's time to converge all my fleets, and it turns out, as I've said before, submarines love to hide at bases. It turns out it was hiding. It was hiding at Jakarta the whole time. I don't know why Jakarta, but hey, no rhyme or reason with these subs ever. If I wasn't able to get there in time, I was gonna try to get my 1, 2, 3, 4 fleets to all be busy trying to recreate the Steven Spielberg movie 1942, when the Japanese tried to find Hollywood and ended up sinking a Ferris wheel in a tank. Not a very good, I don't think it's considered a very good film, but it is a freaking goofy ass film. It's funny. It's very funny. In reality, though, the only thing that actually did happen, I believe in real life, was I believe only a submarine's deck guns ever hit the mainland. And I believe that was done in 1942. And paranoia was pretty high in the mainland at that point. Meanwhile, the 6th Fleet is going to start by attacking the Cacolot, and resulting in, predictably, a stalemate, unfortunately. But we shall see what happens. As you see, the 5th Fleet seems to be going in the wrong direction. This happens all the time. Unfortunately, I don't know why. And the 6th Fleet gets under attack again, but nothing really came out of that. However, I think we need to see this off right, so I'm actually going to view this fleet battle. Finish it off with an exclamation point. Without it, would I have been able to sink the sub? Absolutely. I would have sunk in 15 days. Are you kidding me? With 3 fleets there? Forget it. It wouldn't have been a contest. But I feel like if we're going to send it off, we're going to have to send it off right by actually viewing the last ship that sinks. That's actually, I think, the first time I've actually done the sinking all warships thing in my last 3 or 4 tries at this, so nice to see. So they start off with a little cheap shot, but hopefully my 3 destroyers will be equal to the task, and it looks like they are. They aren't actually aiming their depth charges elsewhere, which is nice. They are all on target this time, and thanks to one serious shell hit from the Hatsuyuki, we have now beaten up the 11th Fleet, the final casualty. We are done. We have officially done it. defeated every single warship in the Pacific. Definitely can proclaim this victory. And how would that change war for the Axis powers? I honestly don't know. I honestly don't know what the answer to that would be. I'd imagine one of the big things is that America would have kept America preoccupied there. It probably would also have pincered the Soviets, who were busy with Germany as it was, and those battles. But it's all speculation. Unfortunately, the one part about this that kind of sucks is this whole thing, you have to wait for the whole theme to end, which takes a while. And also, the final military report takes absolutely forever, and I actually speed it up. I speed it up, which kind of tells you everything you need to know there. It probably would have taken 10 to 15 minutes at normal speed to finish. But this is PTO from the Japanese side, and the Japanese side I think is very enjoyable to do, especially since you can use the Yamato and beat everything up and play with your aircraft carriers quickly. It's very fun. I think I enjoyed it, and I think I first played when I was 10, but even back then I sort of knew what I was doing, even though my strategy was kind of sloppy at the time. But hey, it didn't matter. And of course I had easy mode, which does exist, and that's why it exists. They're not perfect. The AIs are suspect, and the inconsistent results based off human battles or not do come into play. But I thought it did a good job representing all the action, and Koei Games seemed to be very good at this. And the music was fantastic, if there weren't too many tracks. And I find that the other Koei games that I've played, Operation Europe, Path to Victory, and Liberty or Death, which is a revolutionary war sim, to be generally enjoyable, even though they also have the same flaws with the viewing and the suspect AIs. Another one of my favorite things regarding World War II is actually the board game Axis and Allies, if you've heard of that, which was based in 1942. It was 2 to 5 players, with all the major parties involved, the Allies, US, the UK, and the Soviets, and the Axis, which was Japan and Germany. A game that was really intensive in strategy, where you could buy units and compete for conquest all over the world. And it got really intensive. There was a lot of instructions. I don't think I've ever got through them all, truth be told. But the action got very involved, and the game could take several hours to beat, to complete. So it was a very intensive affair, much like this game, really. This took quite a few hours, and finishing up in June 1942. Even though I finished up in June 1942, I mean, this did take a while. I just don't like the fact that it takes so freaking long. There should have been a fast forward function or something here. Ugh. God, why is this long? I have this sped up. Like, I reiterate this. This is 2.5 minutes, and I believe I have a sped at 4 times speed. So, enough said. But, anyway, I think that is... We're finally at the conclusion of this report, thank goodness, so we can actually see the final scene here, which has some pretty cool music that I like. And you can actually see the clouds, the planes, the ships. I guess you could call it a victory tour of sorts. But it's true. I mean, we are victorious. We took over the Pacific with Japan. Now, will I ever do a run with the Allies? I'm considering it. But I don't think I'm going to get to do that for a while. Honestly, doing the recording, playing it through, and then doing the post-com for it got pretty intensive for me. It kept me out of trouble. I guess that's a good thing. But it did take me a while, and I'm not sure when I want to invest that time again. I would want to do it, though. But it'd be pretty much the same formula, except for maybe a little more waiting, because it is the Allies and all the ships. So, with that in mind, we can wait and see the conclusion of this. As you see, we got the little Japanese ship there on the Japanese flag on the ship there, and ultimately we get to view Mount Fuji, the landmark they chose for Japan. They choose the Golden Gate Bridge for the Americans. So you can actually see the San Francisco's Golden Gate Bridge. But with that in mind, thanks for watching this. I will see you next LP. 40Wear signing off.